Welcome to St. Joseph's Parish on this 31st Sunday in Ordinary Time. A special welcome to Father Jim Bergen, who is celebrating Mass with us today. Those who have died in faith are safe in God's hands, and God will wipe away every tear. Our entrance hymn is number 311, As We Gather at Your Table, number 311. Please stand.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
It's very good to be with you this morning, to be back again in the parish. I think we should all be congratulated for moving our clocks in the right direction. So we'll pray for those who didn't do that. I'm from Divine Word College in Epworth, and we're very happy to have Brother Wayne Till in our community, and also Father Jim Heyer from Springbrook had been a member of our community for many years and is now at our community in Techney, Illinois, near Chicago. And we're always happy when Brother Larry Kiefer returns on home leave from Papua New Guinea. So we're very grateful to have these three Divine Word missionaries from this area. We gather in faith, and we know that Jesus is with us and continues to offer us his mercy and his love.
Lord Jesus, you come to reconcile us to one another and the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
We give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whose gift your faithful offer you right and praiseworthy service, grant, we pray, that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The children are welcome now to gather for their children's liturgy.
A reading from the book of the prophet Malachi. A great king am I, says the Lord of hosts, and my name will be feared among the nations. And now, O priests, this commandment is for you. If you do not listen, if you do not lay it to heart, to give glory to my name, says the Lord of hosts, I will send a curse upon you, and of your blessing I will make a curse. You have turned aside from the way, and have caused many to falter your instruction. You have made void the covenant of Levi, says the Lord of hosts. I, therefore, have made you contemptible and base before all the people, since you do not keep my ways, but show partiality in your decisions. Have we not all one Father? Has not the one God created us? Why, then, do we break faith with one another, violating the covenant of our fathers? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, we were gentle among you as a nursing mother cares for her children. With such affection for you, we were determined to share with you not only the gospel of God, but our very selves as well. So dearly beloved, had you become to us. You recall, brothers and sisters, our toil and drudgery. Working night and day in order not to burden any of you, we proclaim to you the gospel of God. And for this reason, we too give thanks to God unceasingly, that in receiving the word of God from hearing us, you received not a human word, but, as it truly is, the word of God, which is now at work in you who believe. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus spoke to the crowds and his disciples, saying, "The scribes and the Pharisees have taken their seat on the chair of Moses. Therefore, do and observe all things, whatever they tell you, but do not follow their example. For they preach, but they do not practice. They tie up heavy burdens hard to carry and lay them on people's shoulders, but they will not lift a finger to move them. All their works are performed to be seen. They widen their phylacteries and lengthen their tassels. They love places of honor at banquets, seats of honor in synagogues, greetings in marketplaces, and the salutation, Rabbi. As for you, do not be called Rabbi. You have but one teacher, and you are all brothers. Call no one on earth your father. You have but one father in heaven. Do not be called master. You have but one master, the Christ. The greatest among you must be your servant. Whoever exalts himself will be humbled, but whoever humbles himself will be exalted." The Gospel of the Lord.
In today's gospel, we hear Jesus say to his disciples regarding the scribes and Pharisees, the religious leaders of his time, "Do whatsoever they tell you, but do not follow their example. For they preach, but they do not practice." Now, not all the scribes and Pharisees at that time were like this, but that certainly is a stinging criticism. Jesus basically is calling them hypocrites. And we might find ourselves hearing this challenging criticism of hypocrisy and feel relieved that Jesus is talking about the scribes and Pharisees. He's not talking about us. But of course, God's word never lets us off quite that easily. And hopefully we're not like the hypocrites Jesus was challenging in today's gospel. But he is inviting us, I'm sure, to look honestly at our own lives and to notice any traces, even, of hypocrisy that we might find. Any times, for example, when we find ourselves saying, "Do what I say, not what I do," or any times when our words and our actions don't quite seem to go together. One time, a couple had invited some people to dinner, and the wife was working very hard all day preparing the meal and getting things ready. And it turned out to be a lot more time and energy than she expected. But finally, everything was ready. The guests arrived and everyone was seated around the table. And so she asked her 6-year-old daughter to say the blessing before they started to eat. And the daughter said, "Well, I wouldn't know what to say." And she said, well, just say a prayer that you've heard mommy say." So the little girl bowed her head and prayed, "Dear God, why did I invite these people to dinner?" Sometimes we get caught. Sometimes the image we want to convey isn't quite what matches what's in our hearts. Jesus is calling us to be genuine and to be sincere in our responses to him and in our dealings with our brothers and sisters. And the word sincere comes from the Latin sine chera, which means without wax. Now, apparently in ancient Roman times, if a statue was cracked or broken, people would use wax to patch it, to hide the cracks, to make the statue look better than it really was. A good statue was sine chera, without wax. It was genuine. Jesus calls us to be genuine and sincere, to be people of integrity who do what we say, who practice what we preach, who don't try to impress people with our image. And I think another test of our sincerity and our genuineness as followers of Jesus is our willingness to be of service to other people. And in today's gospel, Jesus offers us this challenge. The greatest among you must be your servant. And this was a further difficulty Jesus had with at least some of the scribes and Pharisees. They were really impressed with their own greatness. And they looked down on other people instead of walking with them and being of service to them. Jesus asks us to walk alongside each other. Beginning today, we celebrate Vocation Awareness Week, sponsored by the U.S. Catholic Bishops. And I'd encourage you to read the excellent article in the Catechist Corner of today's bulletin. You don't have to do that right now, but I'd invite you to look at that later. As people of faith, we know that our vocation is a call from God. And our basic vocation comes to us through our baptism, our call to follow Jesus. Jesus calls each of us to holiness. That's not just for canonized saints. He calls us to respond as generously as we can to his invitation to live the gospel values, the values we see him living and teaching. He calls us certainly to be of service to our brothers and sisters as we see his loving service throughout the gospels. And we know as our journey continues and as we grow in our faith, at some point, Jesus invites us to choose the way of life in which we can follow him and be of service to others, whether as a single person, a married person, a deacon, a consecrated religious sister, brother, or priest, or a diocesan priest. Our church needs each of these vocations, and we need each other's prayer and support as we respond to the call of Jesus in our own particular vocation. And we know that we are not called to follow Jesus just as isolated individuals. We're called as a community of faith. And the gifts and talents of each person are critical to enable a parish to be a life-giving presence of Jesus, to have the kind of impact on our world that our world desperately needs. So God bless all of you who give your time and energy to the various ministries that are so important to the life of this parish. And certainly among the many possible ministries, our church does need people who are willing to follow Jesus as deacons, religious sisters and brothers, diocesan and religious priests. And I think this week is maybe a special time for us to pray that more people will respond to Jesus' call to serve the church in these various vocations. And I would invite the young people who are here today to keep listening prayerfully to the call of Jesus. And as you're reflecting on what that call might be, what vocation you might be interested in, I'd ask you just to wonder if he's inviting you to religious life or to ordained ministry or even to be a missionary. We know for sure that Jesus never calls us to a way of life that's going to make us miserable. He just doesn't do that. He calls us always to a way of life that will bring us a deep sense of happiness and peace, and he's always right there with us as we respond to whatever challenges and difficulties we might experience in our particular vocation. I'm personally very grateful for the call I received to be a Divine Word missionary. I appreciate the support I receive from the brothers and priests that I live with. And the opportunity to serve as a priest has been a genuine joy and a real privilege for me. I've been at it for a long time,
and I've enjoyed every bit of it. And a real blessing has been the wonderful, wonderful people I've been able to meet through my ministry. As we celebrate this Eucharist, may we continue to pray for each other as each of us does our very best to respond to the call that Jesus has given to us.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. In him all things were made. For us, for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered death, and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. Come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting always in God's loving presence with us, we pray.
For prophets and martyrs, for eloquent preachers and caring pastors, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our veterans, grant them strength and peace of mind. Support them in infirmity and the fragility of old age. Teach us to remember their sacrifices and to express our gratitude for their service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For safety and favorable weather for the harvesting of crops, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who hear Jesus' call to vocations within the church, may our community support and encourage those with contemplating vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, religious life, and lay ecclesial ministry. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the ill and disabled, for those who care for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are gathered here, for those who mourn, for those who comfort, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the people of our parishes and those who are being remembered in this Mass who have died, Edna Leonard, Tom and Jeanette Drells, and Eugene Schultes, that they may know the fulfillment of God's promise of eternal life and everlasting joy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious God, we know that you hear us as we pray. We thank you for all the ways you bless us, and we make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our song for the preparation of the gifts is number 323, To Be Your Bread, number 323. Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifices at your hands to the praise and glory of his name, for the good of all his holy church.
May these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation, and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At our Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us
this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our song for communion is number 374, Servant Song number 374.
Let us pray. May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving what they promise through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
There will be ecumenical choir practice November 12th and 19th at 8:15 a.m. at St. John's Lutheran Church. And our church pictorial directories may be picked up today in the back.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is number 558, O Bless the Lord, number 558.